This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about dividing decimals. So let's say we have 0.17, and we want to divide that by 0.4. Now, we're going to do division of decimals in just about the same way we do any long division problem. So I'm going to set this up like a long division problem. I'll put in that box that I normally use for long division. I'll take the dividend, the number that's being divided at 0.17, put that inside the box. And I'll take the divisor, 0.4, and put it to the left of the box. And now what we want to do before we start is turn the divisor into a whole number. I can turn a decimal into a whole number by moving its decimal point all the way to the right. So in this case, I'm going to move the decimal point one place to the right, and now the divisor is just 4. I have to do the same thing for the dividend, the number that's being divided. So I move its decimal point one place to the right, and now it's just become 1.7. Let me explain why I can do that. If I take the original problem, 0.17 divided by 0.4, I could write that as a fraction. I could write 0.17 over 0.4, and then I could multiply that fraction by 10 over 10, which is just multiplying it by 1. When I multiply by 10, I shift the decimal point one place over to the right. So the numerator is now going to become 1.7. The denominator will become a whole number. It'll become 4. So that's basically what I did down here where I set up my problem. Okay, so let me just clean this up. I'm dividing 4 into 1.7. Now I know there's going to be a decimal point in the answer, so I'll write a decimal point where the quotient goes above the box, directly above the decimal point in the dividend. And now I can start dividing. I want to divide 4 into 1. Well, it doesn't go, so I'll just put a 0 there before the decimal point. Now I'm going to try to divide 4 into 17. 4 goes into 17 4 times, and 4 times 4 is 16. I'm going to subtract 17 minus 16 is 1, and this is where I would normally bring down the next digit. Well, I haven't got another digit. All I've got is 1.7, but realize that 1.7 is the same as 1.70, so I can add another digit. As long as I'm at the right end of my decimal point, of my decimal, I can just keep adding as many zeros as I want. So I've added the 0, I'll bring it down, and now I want to divide 4 into 10. Well, 4 goes into 10 2 times, and 2 times 4 is 8. I subtract, I get a 2, and I'll bring down another 0. So I'll add a 0 to this decimal, the dividend, bring that 0 down, and I've got 4 divided into 20. That goes 5 times. 5 times 4 is 20, and I've got a 0 remainder. So my answer is going to be 0.425. Now, you might want to check at this point and make sure your decimal point is in the right place. A simple way to do that would be this. Count the number of decimal places that you've got in your dividend after you've added any zeros you had to. So I've got 3 decimal places in the dividend. Make sure you have the same number of decimal places in your answer, in the quotient. And I do. I have 3 decimal places in my quotient. So as long as you've got the same number of decimal places in both the dividend and the quotient, you've probably done it right. Okay, so that's the basic process. Take care. I'll see you next time.